and today we're with Mr. Markus Mueller, who is Vice President of Sales and Marketing Asia for Moevenpick Hotels and Resorts. Good morning to you, Mr. Mueller.
Steve, good morning to you.
Now, here we are, Moevenpick. It is a very happening hotel company at the moment. You're developing at a reasonably rapid rate within Asia Pacific. Could you just tell us, what are your projections and plans for the next couple of years here in the Asia Pacific marketplace?
Well, Stephen, the hospitality industry is an exciting business, as you know. We're just about to announce our 100th property worldwide. We have two openings this year in Thailand, and it is an exciting time.
Right. Now, the 100th property, where will that be?
Well, that's a good question. I mean, if we talk about opening or that probably changes, we hope it's obviously in Asia, right? So depends on the building speed, if you so will, the end of, yeah.
Right. Now, in Asia Pacific, how many hotels do you have currently operational open at the moment?
Well, we have 6 hotels open in Asia. We're a very small operation in Asia still. The first hotel in Asia was the Karen Beach in Phuket.
Right. And in terms of the opening, those are the 6 hotels that you have open now. Are there any hotels, how many are opening this year within Asia Pacific?
Well, in Asia Pacific, we have 2 more hotels in Thailand. We have the Koh Samui Hotel. It's a villa, small villa product, a beautiful beach, 81 villas, and a hotel in Chiang Mai opening, so, right in the city center.
Right. Now, there obviously we're focusing on Thailand, but there are other very exciting developments within other parts of the region. Which other countries within Asia Pacific are you looking at?
Well, obviously, we're looking at China as well. Our first hotel in China is going to open in Sanya. We're excited about that one. It's a beautiful property, Phoenix Island. We are looking at clusters. So Philippines is obviously on our eye and our radar.
And in terms of the development pipeline, we've obviously mentioned that you have 2 hotels in Thailand opening this year. Do you have any signed contracts within Asia Pacific? Because as you say, Sanya's coming up. Any more properties in the pipeline?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, look, I mean, we're going into Shanghai as well, Jiading, Shanghai. We're going into Shifeng, which is in Mongolia. Haven't been there yet, no, but it's a beautiful property. I mean, some stunning designers from New York. As I said, the Philippines, there's some hotels coming up. And
are you looking mainly at beach properties, or are you looking at a mixture of city hotels and beach resorts? And is it the same brand that you're looking at in terms of development? How does that work?
Yeah, we have one brand. I mean, we have more brands as Moevenpick as a group. I mean, I think the unique thing about the brand, Moevenpick, is we have capabilities in different areas. If you saw, we have different product lines. We have fine foods, we have wine, we have hotels and resorts, and we have what we call systematic gastronomy, which is another brand which we own is Marche, but we don't have hotels in that brand.
Right.
Marche is the concept food and beverage.
Right. Yeah. When you look at the other major companies, hotel companies in the industry, they tend to have a lot of different diversified brands spreading from budget all the way up to the upper end, 5 stars and what have you. Do you think there's a room for development within Asia Pacific for branching out into luxury economy and mid-market brands? Is it something that Moevenpick will be doing?
Well, look, absolutely. It's all the question where you're going to put your focus, all right? Is there a potential for difference? Absolutely. You know, would you have more segmentation? You know, would you target a bigger segmentation if you have more brands? Absolutely. Now, but it's the same thing. You know, you have only limited resources available. Where are you going to make the biggest impact? We believe the money is being made for us in the upscale sector.
Right. And in the upscale sector, what is it you're looking for? Are you looking for rebranding hotels? Are you looking for new builds primarily? What sort of projects are you actually looking for?
Well, we're looking for both, actually. It's got to fit to the brand. It's got to match. I mean, we're a Swiss hotel company, right? Moevenpick comes as a heritage and fine foods and food and beverage. It's got to fit the image and the experience of a brand.
Right. And how does a Moevenpick resort differ from a Moevenpick city hotel, apart from the obvious?
Obviously, other than the resort and the city hotel, you mean?
Yes.
In terms of philosophy and brand experience?
Yes.
There's different customer needs, obviously. I mean, every hotel, if you so will, has a little bit of different delivery. I mean, it's a purpose of visit, which is important. It's a customer, which is important. I think the framework for the brand delivery, as I said, for us, it's authenticity, it's passionately Swiss. This is a framework we operate in, but it's going to be translated differently in Thailand, as it is in Sentosa, as it is in Saigon.
Right. tried.
Okay.
With the brand, what is your thoughts on new technology? For example, there's a lot of new technology with things such as self-check-in technology. There's also a new trend of 24-hour check-in. What is your and Moevenpick's philosophy and thinking about such technologies?
Well, Steve, that depends again. Obviously, you're all very keen and interested in technology, right? However, technology is just a tool, and we're going to understand what the customer wants, you know? For example, I mean, today, yes, in resort hotels, I think it's almost a must that you have Wi-Fi across the resort hotels, which you think, even so you're there for leisure, but still Wi-Fi, you know, the internet becomes such a part of our lives, the social media sector. You want to connect to your Facebook friends when you're on holiday, you want to share the latest pictures. So I think in that sense, you know, absolutely. But we got to look very carefully, because if you go on a trend, you know, it's like you can buy every 6 months a new iPhone if you want to nowadays. So you got to really look what your customer wants and which makes sense, and how you use technology to your advantage. Yes, we're looking at it, and yes, we're using it, and where we think it's where it's appropriate.
Right. You mentioned their basic technology of being the internet and Wi-Fi and what have you. There are other hotel companies, Best Western, Shangri-La, Wyndham, Carlson. Across all their brands, they offer complimentary internet regardless of room rates. Yeah. Is this something that Moevenpick is doing now, or is it something you'll be possibly implementing in the future?
Depends on the location again, Steve. I mean, nowadays, from a consumer, you probably argue all the time, it's gotta be free of charge, right? Now, if a market, everybody's charging, why would you get rid of it, right? And you know, how should I say that? I mean, so there's a couple of companies in the intermediaries, right? A lot of hotels are tied into contracts, you know, for years and so on. So it is obviously, it's not as easy as it sounds, maybe, because it depends on the supplier and the whole, the supplier for internet and some of the countries' regulations, actually.
Right. Now, I'd like to ask you about Sentosa for a moment. Sentosa has seen so much development in recent times. Yep. Resorts World Sentosa and other projects there. How is the hotel in Sentosa doing?
Well, it's doing fantastic. Singapore, I mean, the figures, I mean, just, if you think about it, with the opening of the Resort World and such, and even the other integrated resort in the city. I think that the figures are just sky high. I mean,
have you managed to attract much corporate business from the city centre, or is it primarily a lot more leisure trips?
Primarily leisure trips. Yeah. MICE is obviously there. I mean, meetings in the centres is obviously, if you refer to corporate. But I think it's predominantly, obviously, it's leisure
right.
location.
Right. Now, we should have maybe done this at the beginning. But what is a Moevenpick hotel? What can people expect from a Moevenpick that possibly differs them from other hotels?
Well, Stephen, that's a good question. What it differs, I mean, to me. I refer to it, I mean, as you know, if you check in at Moevenpick, we're kind of like I refer to it as we're the Corona of the beer brands, okay? We're a little bit more fun, we're a little bit different. And I think that's something which other hotel companies not necessarily can say, because we're coming from a fine food background and ice cream, as you know, which is a little bit more fun. And I think when it comes to this expectations and that delivery, I think that's a unique experience which we can provide at Moevenpick.
Right. Now, you mentioned there, obviously, food is a big part of Moevenpick.
Yeah.
Marche is a very popular concept in many different markets. You've had some success in some markets in Asia-Pacific and less so in others. Does every single Moevenpick have a Marche restaurant?
No, it does not. It's a separate product line, completely. And we operate as a different brand, right? It's a whole different target audience. I mean, Moevenpick is an upscale brand, right? Marche is not upscale. It's probably more mid-scale, mid-scale brand. I mean, I cannot talk for Marche, but it's not. That's why it's a different brand.
Right. Yeah. But all of the restaurants and F&B outlets that you do at the properties, they're all self-managed. You don't franchise out, or do you?
No, we manage.
Right.
Yeah.
And in terms of that, what types of food and beverages? Is there a constant across the brands, across the hotels?
No, we don't believe in that. It depends on your location and your purpose of visit. After all, it depends on the whole customer mix. And you want to exceed your customer expectations, right? And we don't believe in that cookie-cutter principle. That's not what Moevenpick is about, right? Moevenpick is providing authentic experiences.
Excellent. Well, it sounds like a very exciting future with Moevenpick. Definitely. Here we are at the ATF in Manado in Indonesia. Which other trade shows do you have planned to attend in 2012?
Well, we're looking heavily, obviously we're going to the big ones and ITB Berlin, we're doing the ITB Asia and Rail in Singapore. But I think the future goals for us is obviously the regional. The trend is clearly to the regional areas for us in Asia. And we're looking into Korea. Korea is an important market for us and it's growing.
And finally, the last question for you is very much with regards to the internet and the rates. Here we are at the trade show with the ATF. A lot of travel agents, a lot of wholesalers and operators coming to you. With regards to the best available rate on your website, is that the best place to buy? Do you offer a guarantee? If somebody finds it cheaper elsewhere, do you offer a guarantee? How does that work, please?
Yes. The answer is yes, Stephen, of course. Like any other hotel chain, I would say nowadays. I mean, that's what you want to do. That's what you want to promote. And yes, we offer a guarantee. But yes, it's the best available rate.
Okay, excellent. In that case, Mr. Mueller, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, the best of luck here at the ATF.
All right, then. Thank you, Steve.